Anywhere else in London.
Freddy, I hardly recognized you in your police togs.
You certainly scrub up well.
I thank you for your help in collecting these bounties. I am impressed with all you have accomplished, and I wish you luck with your future endeavors.
Everything you've ever wanted.
you've done a wonderful job of helping the children of this city.
So what you're saying is, I'm a hero.
We pitched in what we could to properly express our gratitude.
Thank you, Clara.
Good. You're both here. I have something to give you.
That really isn't necessary.
More gifts? You spoil me, Greenie.
Templar numbers are dwindling, and I hate to admit it, but the Rooks are thriving.
Did you hear that, Evie? Thriving.
Your time in London has been well spent. I am proud of you.
Thank you. The aura of death surrounds thee both.
Get thee behind me!
Alas, these days, stupidity is all too prevalent. You know, I never asked your names when we last met.
I'm Evie Fry, and this is my brother Jacob.
Tell me, do you believe in ghosts?
Not particularly.
Yes.
I'm skeptical myself. Here we are, in the world's most advanced city, yet its citizens are so enthralled to the supernatural, they leave themselves vulnerable to charlatans. Which is why I joined the Ghost Club. The first society in the world to look systematically at the phenomenon. Because truth, like a spirit, must be cajoled before it will reveal itself. Will you join us?
Sounds absolutely ridiculous.
Why not?
It does sound intriguing.
Splendid. I have your first case. There's been some disturbing reports about a series of assaults in Lambeth. People claim they're being attacked by an age-old demon, Springheel Jack. The fiend is no doubt on the prowl as we speak. It's up to you to fight him.
Life itself. Now let's drink to toast. Life itself.
That's a good girl.
It was horrible. Glowing eyes, huge claws, and his laugh. Luckily, he was frightened away by some passers-by. Somebody has to do something before he attacks another.
Looks like he ran this way.
Oh,
Perhaps the legend is true and he does have giant claws. Looks like he ran this way. A heavily guarded warehouse. I wonder what they're heavily guarding.
Thank you. our inspiration from death. No, the lower classes.
Something of interest. If you're pleased, I'm pleased.
Tell me, this all side
of it. I'm having a lie down and you forget it.
I'll give you a damn good hiding!
Been a spate of rather intriguing thefts about town recently.
Robberies in London are hardly supernatural events.
They look like common robberies at first, but these perpetrators have all claimed to have been under the influence of some supernatural power. I'm not so foolish as to forget that criminals will spin any yarn to avoid the law. However, These thieves all proffer the same defense. They say they were being controlled by a demon. Will you make some inquiries? One of our demon-possessed mobsmen is being held behind bars at this very moment. You may want to begin your search there.
At home, of course, they'll be storming.
What's that man done?
Robbed the pawnbrokers down the road.
A demon made me do it. I can't remember much. That's what's so queer. I've never stolen anything in my life before.
Let's pretend that I believe you. Tell me who made you do it.
All I can recall is a silver watch swinging in midair. It was held by someone or something. A dark presence whispering. I could only see its eyes. A demon.
I'll need to verify this with the shopkeeper.
That's not to say you both have bad names.
We're proud of our names.
Good English.
Thank you.
But Helga wants to show us.
What can you tell me about the robbery?
There's not much to say. Most of the items did come from the same seller. Enzio Capelli, Sorcerer Supreme, a famous showman from Italy. Several weeks ago, he was forced to pawn his family heirlooms, debts. I have the address of the last person who redeemed something of his. A lovely pearl necklace. That helpful?
Not again! Stop her! Stop! Somebody stop that thief!
You took something from a pawn shop.
There's some sort of scuffle over there.
It's all very hazy, but I remember something silver flashing in front of my eyes. Then I heard a sort of bell. Next thing I know, I'm here with you.
My only lead is this mysterious buyer.
It's
This chap might lead me to the demon.
Childish of her.
Whatever she's doing there, I want no part of it.
Mr. Enzio Capelli, I presume? So you're responsible for the theft of your own jewels?
You are very much mistaken, aren't you, my child?
Yes, I'm very much mistaken. Hold on.
You are very much mistaken. And now you are so very, very tired, aren't you?
Yes, I'm very, very tired.
Now, you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
My goodness, what foul behavior.
What's going on? Where am I?
You've been arrested for theft.
How very intriguing.
I can't remember a jot of it.
Let's get you out of here. I've pulled a few strings, and they won't prosecute on account of your losing your mind. Be free, little chicken. Truly no recollection of the events that landed you in a cell?
My mind is blank, save for the glint of a silver object, the toll of a bell, and a presence of some sort.
A glint of silver and a tolling bell. Oh, hey. I must say, you look very tired.
Yes. I'm so very, very tired.
Now you're going to do a little job of work for me, aren't you?
Now I'm going to do a little job of work for you.
You've cost me a bit of money, mate. So I think it's only fair that you replenish my coffers with donations from the good people of London. You will steal money for me, won't you?
Yes. I will steal money for you.
Thank you. away from me, you dodger!
Good. Very good. Now, we can't have criminals like you roaming the streets. You will surrender to the police, won't you?
Yes, I will surrender to the police.
Oh, and when you do, you're going to do a silly little dance for them.
About a man named Ezio.
I was hypnotized by Ezio Capelli, not a demon after all. Nor Italian, for that matter.
I suspected hypnotism from the very start. You must find the villain.
for money.
Once. I admit it. I'm not Italian. It was just for my act. Nobody wanted to see a British hypnotist.
I don't care.
I'll give you anything you want.
I would like you to be quiet. Are you a contemporary of Dr. Elliotson?
Never heard of the man.
Mesmerism as a criminal enterprise was not a bright idea.
How dare you? I'm a hypnotist. He doesn't bend that way!
You will make reparations for your crimes and liberate the innocents you've used.
Thank you.
How nice to see you again, Mr. Dickens. Is it time for another of the Ghost Club stories?
As a matter of fact, yes. Follow me. Number 50, Berkeley Square. Four stories high and branded, Beware All Those Who Enter. There have been many strange tales of this dreadful domicile. The earliest report of a haunting was said to be the specter of a small girl who was murdered by a servant. She could be seen at the attic windows, weeping and wringing her little hands in an agony of despair. You're not afraid, are you? I'm eager to begin. Another legend claims the attic is haunted by the spirit of a young woman who purportedly threw herself from the top floor windows to escape her abusive uncle. Her screaming ghost has reportedly been sighted hanging from the window ledge. This residence was briefly owned by a Mr. James Jasper, a choir master and an opium addict. His nephew Edward was betrothed to one of Mr. Jasper's pupils, the fair and delicate Rose. However, Edward disappeared under mysterious circumstances, followed by Jasper himself. Perhaps grief sent him back to the soothing arms of his narcotic mistress. Shall we? Though this house is vacant, some say it comes alive at night with screams of terror, ringing bells, and slamming shutters. Although eerie, this phenomenon is easily produced by pneumatic tubes and valves. There are claims that a young man was caged in the attic, his only connection to the rest of the world, a tiny hole in the door. A young man who was reduced to madness by this extreme isolation. The legends all seem to focus on one room in particular. A sudden draft, nothing more. My word, perhaps I shall wait here while you investigate the source of that laughter, which is not at all unsettling.
Now tell me, why were you at that house?
What's it to you?
Out with it.
All right. We were there for the treasure. We found a key to the secret passage.
What secret passage?
Yeah, number 50's got a secret passage. Here, take it. Just leave me be.
I've found a lock, but I haven't located the key.
It's here.
So this is how it works.
Impressive.